Hi, welcome back to the workshop. It's been a while, sorry, had a lot of things going on in my life. But today we are going to go through a carburetor rebuild, carburetor for the Fiat 500, which will be the Weber 26, which comes on all the 500s. It's very similar to the 126, it's slightly different. I will go through a Weber 28, which is what comes on a 126. This is an original Weber, not a Polish one, as you can see from the markings on here. So what you'll need to overhaul one of these is a Timmel ratchet or even spanner, 19mm flathead and a Phillips screwdriver, also a carburetor rebuild kit for your specific carburetor, whether it's a 26 or 28. I would also recommend replacing the carburetor base. Now, these carburetors are pretty simple. The only thing that really goes wrong with them is block jets. But the other main thing is the base tends to get warped because people over tighten these, so it becomes concave. So let me just tilt the camera down a little bit. So let me show you something. One second. So, in fact, so what you want to do is you want to, let me take this off a minute. So what you want to do really is you want to take your carburetor and you want to put it onto a flat, like a flat base. Now, if your carburetor does this, the bottom is warped, as you can see. It doesn't sit flat at all. So that's going to cause all sorts of issues like air leaks. It's going to run poorly. So there's several different options you can do. You can either gently hit it with a hammer, gently on each end, try and tap it back into place. You can either take it to a machine shop and have them just skim the bottom of it, or you can put some sandpaper on a flat surface and you can run it backwards and forwards like so till it becomes flat and even. I'm going to do it on this one, but off camera, because I don't want to bore you. But that is something to look out for, because if you have a look here how it's sitting, can you see it's warped? So a lot of the times this is put onto the plastic spacer, people think it's bolted down tightly, and it's, well, it is, but it's still letting in air, so it runs badly. And again, that comes from over tightening these carburetors. It's a common thing. So let me just pop you back on the camera stand. And yeah, that's better. Can you see me, guys? Yeah, you can see me. Cool. I'm gonna just move you a little bit this way. Cool. So what we're gonna start by doing, and again, the other thing is, this one someone's actually tried to paint. If you actually have a look, someone's actually painted the surface of this to try and make it look new. Do not sandblast your carburetors, people, because the fine sand particles will get inside the carburetor. You will never get them out in a million years. If you want to clean these or make the metal look like new, you want to do what I do, and that's use a little sandblasting cabinet, but with soda. So you soda blast it. And the reason why is when you clean it after in the ultrasonic cleaner, which I have over there, the soda dissolves in the water, so it doesn't block up any of the pores of the carburetor. So that's really what you want to be doing. Anyway, you want to start by taking the little cap off here, which is self-explanatory. Again, any part of this video you want to skip through, please skip through to the part you want to learn about. So we'll take this off. Make sure you have a tray as well for your small parts. I have some inserts here. So let's take this one off. Now, this is meant to be 210s, but someone actually replaced this with something a bit bigger. Looks like a 12. 1 second. Let's have a could be an 11mm. Yes, someone's replaced that one with an 11, which is a bit of a strange size, but never mind. So let's take this off. And again, keep all your bits separately, that way you will know what goes back where. So after you've taken the top off, let's undo this 19mm nut here. This is on top of the inlet. This holds the filter. Shouldn't be too tight. There you go, that wasn't too tight at all. Just unscrew that, put it to one side. There's a fiber washer on it. Leave it on there so you remember to put it on later. And then inside here, you will see a little filter just there. Just take some long nose pliers, grab it and pull it out like that. And you can see just how dirty that is. And it's just full of crusty fuel. So we'll put that to one side as well. After you've done that, you can see what's inside there. Four flathead screws. Take a screwdriver to that and crack them open. They shouldn't be too tight. Let's open these up and put these to one side. Just like so. And then the other two here. One. And the other one, which is here. So now we should be able to release the top of the carburetor with the float. So take that out. Now you should be able to lift the top of the carburetor off. Okay, and off it comes. On the top part, you have the float. Okay, you have the little valve at the top there, and you have the gasket on the bottom. This is the base of the carb. As you can see, there's a lot of debris inside and rubbish. Now I will come to what all these are inside in a minute. Next thing, the two flathead screws here to take the choke mechanism off the side. Again, someone's painted this, so I will be soda blasting it. But I will also ultrasonically clean it first. So, choke mechanism off. There's no gasket on the choke mechanism, it just fits directly onto the body. So, to wiggle that off, and inside there you have the choke mechanism. Okay, that I'll put to one side here. The next thing you want to take out, you want to start taking the jets out. So this here is the idle jet in the side here. That's the idle jet. So that should come out. Again, flathead screwdriver, shouldn't be too tight. As you can see, someone's tried to spray this carburetor to make it look like new. I personally wouldn't do that. That's the idle jet. So we'll put that again to one side so we know what it is. And then the screw below with the spring, that is the that's the idle mixture adjustment screw, so we'll take that out as well. That looks like that. It's dirty, but that's what it looks like. So the next thing we're left with is the main jet on the back. Take that, should be a 10mm, so we'll take that off and we shall take that off from here. That should unscrew like so, and here we have our main jet. The actual jet is removable from the top. You need to put it in a vise and undo it. I can't do it with my hands, but that main jet is actually changeable, so we'll put that to one side for the moment. Right, next we're going to take out the choke jet, which is this one there. And again, we'll put it to one side. They should all come out pretty easily. They shouldn't be too tight. That's the choke jet, this long one here. Then we have all the auxiliary airways here, which also come out like so. Just unscrew them. This one in the middle, yeah, that you can see is another piece that comes out down there. It's not going to come out that easily. I can get it out at a later date. Maybe with a poker.
Yeah, it's got another piece down here which should come out, which doesn't. This little snap ring comes out of here, okay, for the choke. And it's got a long spring inside it. Okay, it's just got that little snap ring that sits in the top. Three pieces here, as you can see. And they go inside there. So I'm gonna put them to one side as the choke mechanism here on the bench. And then we'll take out what's inside here, which is this slider piece here. That comes out of there. Okay, that's for the choke. So we'll put that to one side as well. What next have we got to do? I'm sure that comes out. Maybe I'm wrong. No, it doesn't come out. So, now I've taken the carburetor completely to bits. I've left the butterfly in place. Unless you're going to replace it. This specific kit doesn't have another butterfly. So I've left the butterfly in place and I've left the screw in place for adjusting the idle speed. I could actually take it out, but I've left it in for the moment. So this is the actual base of the carburetor stripped down. The other thing is the middle of the Venturi comes out as well. If you wobble it, there you go. That's the middle of the Venturi. So that's out as well. So we can clean it all properly. Also put that to one side. So in essence, this is what you're left with. Okay, so now that's stripped down, I'm going to put that to one side and let's concentrate on the top piece. So we have the float to take out now. So there is a pin in the side of the float which should pull out. If you grab a pair of long nose pliers and just pull it out. There's a slitted side there and a non-slitted side. It comes out this way and goes in this way. So I'm going to put the pin again to one side here. I'll put the float to one side. I'll show you in a minute how to test your floats to make sure they're okay. This has got original metal ones. Some of them are plastic. And then you have your needle, your float needle, which is here, which comes out the middle of there. Ooh. Okay, so just take your float needle out. You'll have a new one in your set. Take your 10 mil and just crack it open like so. And the whole assembly should come out like so. You can actually discard that float needle because you'll have a brand new one in your carburetor set. So that can actually go to one side. And then all you have is your paper gasket here, which should, if you ease it gently, try and ease it as gently as possible to get it up as a whole, should lift off like this. And again, you can discard that. So this is what you're left with. Okay, now it's all ready for cleaning. So now I have soda blasted everything, so you can see the finish the soda blasting gives you. It's a really nice satin finish and it gets rid of all the grime and dirt, all the bits and pieces, including the carburetor itself. Again, like I said, soda blasting is safe because it dissolves in water or an ultrasonic cleaner, so you won't get any bits stuck down the little tiny holes because it will dissolve because it's soda. Float valve, everything is all nice and clean. Needles and stuff, I'm just cleaned up the end, but the actual needles themselves, I'm just going to put in the ultrasonic. I didn't blast them because I don't want to change the sizes of the holes or anything. And all they need is the ultrasonic and they should be absolutely fine. So let's take these bits and pieces off here. So what I'm going to do is get that off because I just stuck this on for blasting. Although we have a new one, but I just don't want to blast any threads or anything. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to stick these in the ultrasonic cleaner. I'm going to go and grab the tray from the cleaner, which is here. I'm going to give it a six-minute wash. Let me just pull you this way. Let me just pull you this way and I will show you. So basically I'm going to put all the big bits and pieces into the cleaner here. So let's take the tray out for a minute. It's a bit wet, but we'll stick it on the bench. We'll lay all the bits and pieces inside here. All the big bits can go in here that don't fall down the mesh. So that and that, this and this. What I normally do with the small bits, I'll grab something like a little tray. I've got this plastic back box and I'll stick all the small bits inside here. You can use a metal tray if you want. This is just what I have to hand, like this. That, those bits I don't need to because they're not being reused apart from the needle that holds the float valve in and the screws I've cleaned up on the wire wheel. So I'll put them in here like so. And I'll stick this in while I'm at it as well. But it actually is new, I don't need to. So all of these go into the ultrasonic cleaner. Just lower it down like this really gently. Obviously that back box is going to float till I fill it with a little bit of water. Like so, and it'll sink to the bottom, but it keeps all the little parts safe. Now I'm going to start it on 6 minutes and see how they come out. Okay, now it's finished. Let's take our parts out. And take the strainer out, like so. Oh, that box has still got water in it. Plonk it down there. I'm going to take these parts now and I'm going to blow them out. Now I've got the parts out of the parts washer, I'm just going to blow them out with the air gun. And clean. This way you just make sure that there's no water left in any of the holes. If you haven't got an air gun, you can just hand dry them and use a hair dryer maybe. Put that back there and we'll take the bits over to the bench now and we'll start rebuilding our cleaned carburetor. Now we have all the bits on the bench that are clean, we can start reassembling the carburetor. So I think the first thing to do is take the base of the carb and start reinserting all the jets that we have taken out. First, I'm going to put the choke mechanism in. So just do it the opposite way we did it. So this goes in first, like so. Then the big spring, like so. And then we have this little bit here, exactly the opposite way, that sits on top. And then we have the clip that pushes down on that and it just clips in. I'm just gonna do this down here because it's a bit hard to do with one hand. I'm just gonna take my little pokey tool and I'm just going to push that clip down home. It'll just clip in like that. There we go, so that's in. So what you should end up looking like, something like this. And if you have a look, see, it should be free and bounce up and down like this on the spring. That means you've inserted it correctly. Then we'll take the jets. I've blown all the jets out as well, because it's also a good idea if you have a compressor and an airline, just to blow down the holes, or you can use your mouth, just to make sure they're clear, see if you can see light down there. I wouldn't try and wire wheel them or use a wire brush or anything that might change the shape or the size of these jets. So let's start inserting the ones that come out from inside. So the one next to the choke spring is this long one that goes in here like so. And we'll just tighten that down like so. Again, just nip it, don't over tighten it. Wrong screwdriver, but yeah. Don't over tighten it, just nip it. It doesn't need to be that tight. We then have this little jet that goes in here, like so. I don't know what you guys can see, but I will show you in a minute. So the inside of your carburetor should look something like that. Okay. Once we've done that, let's take the idle needle. Again, I've just cleaned it. I haven't wire wheeled it, tried to make it look shiny. I don't want to change the contour of this needle. And if I put this on the wire wheel, or even if I blast it, there is a chance I could change the size and the shape of it. I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to slip the spring over it. All I did was just clean the head up, just so it looks nice. I'll take the idle needle, which I haven't blasted. I've just cleaned it because I don't want to change the shape or the size of it. And this goes right back into where it came from, which is here. I'm just going to screw that in for the moment. I've not set it up at all. I've just literally just screwed it in. So it's there. We can do all the settings after. Right. Once I've done that, I'm going to also take the inside of the carburetor and put it back in to where it belongs. If you see on this piece, there's a hole in one side, no hole on the other side. The piece with the hole goes towards the back of the carburetor. I don't know how much you can see there, but there is like a joining hole there that matches up to that hole. So that goes in this way. I'm not sure if there's an arrow on here, but there is a chamfer actually. You can see on this. Can you see it's slightly chamfered on one side? That side goes down. So line that up. Reinsert that back in like so. What am I going to do next? Let's put this choke mechanism on next. This just screws on. There's no gaskets or anything. It just should locate just like that. And that moves the needle inside. So that should just go on like so. We'll just put the two screws back into here. Again, just tighten. So we'll put this to one side. We have in our kit, which comes in a box like this, which there's a lot of the Fiat places sell these. You'll get new gaskets for the top and the bottom of the carburetor. Well, for the bottom of the carburetor base and the top of the carburetor base. One sits on the head, one sits on the bottom of the carb. You've also got the gasket for the intake pipe that sits on top. You have a new needle, okay, float needle. You have a strainer, a new strainer, and a couple of washers for a couple of the bits and pieces inside the carburetor. So what I think I'm going to do next is I'm going to take the main jet, which is this one, with a big nut on it, slip the new copper washer on it, like so. I'm going to insert it into the carburetor, into the side here. I'm just going to tighten it up very lightly. Like so. Just nip it, that's it. Going to take this jet as well. Put the other washer that I have in my kit on this, like so. I'm going to insert that into the side of the carburetor also and tighten it up with a screwdriver when I can find it. There we go. And just nip that like so. Done. So that's the bottom of the carburetor actually built. So we've got all our jets in there, all our needles in there, choke mechanisms in there. Butterfly mechanisms, nice and clean and works. So this now we can put to one side. So let's start with the top of our carburetor. So we have now our cleaned top. So what we first want to do is take our new strainer, just plonk it in here like so, just push it down like that. All you have to do, there's the top. Take our new fiber washer, plonk it on like so, put the nut on like so, and just take our ratchet, and it's a bit of a big ratchet, but just nip it up. Doesn't need to be ridiculously tight, just nipped. So you end up with a part looking like this. Okay, and the air should still flow through here. You can just go, just to check that nothing's stuck or obstructing. Our next step is to put our needle in, which we'll get in a kit like so. And they should say 1.25 on them, which this one does. Okay, here's our new needle valve. Just be careful because the inside, the needle comes out of the base. So till you get the float in, it could fall on the floor. Now the float has been, the needle has been assembled. We're going to put the float valve in. What we want to do first is put the gasket in. So the gasket will only go in one way. There's a pin here and there's a little tiny hole there. So the gasket has to go in first. Remember to do that. Grab your float valve this way, like so, and then take your little needle, like so, and feed it through. Ooh. Can't do this while looking at the camera, but yeah. Feed it through the end that's not split first, which is here. Like so, and feed it to the end that's split. If it goes to the end that's split really easily, just squash that split end a little bit just so it grips it. I'm just going to use a pair of pliers just to push it through like so, and that's it. And it grips in there, the needle. If the needle's too loose, see it split, squash it a little bit and it'll stay. So now your float needle is there. Your float is there. So now what we want to do is we need to set the float level. So we need to set how far the float, the float fills up in the chamber before it pushes the needle. So actually, if I hold it this way, as you can imagine, that's sitting inside, the float bowl fills up and then it stops the fuel from coming in. So we need to adjust this so it shuts it off at exactly the right time. So I'll show you how to do that now. So the way to check your float is hold your top assembly upright like this, so this float just sits against the ball. Okay, now you want to take a rule and you want to measure between, I'm going to do this upside down so you can see, the base and the start of the float, and it should be 7 millimeters. You need to check with your kit, but it should be, I'm saying it should be 7 millimeters. Okay, if it's not, then the little tab that hits the needle, you want to bend it very slightly, so when you hold this you have 7 millimeters between the base and the float, and that's your setting for your float. So once that's been adjusted and you have 7 millimeters between the float and the base, you can start to reassemble this back onto the bottom carburetor. Just out of interest, also I forgot to tell you, just check your float valves, or your actual floats. Once you've cleaned them up, just put them in a little cup of water, push them down underneath the water. If they come back up and float, fantastic. If they start to sink, then you've got a problem. Or if you see air bubbles rising up because water's getting inside, then you have an issue. But I forgot to show that to you. Anyway, we can now assemble this onto our carburetor. So let's lower that gently into the carburetor, holding the gasket in place, like so. Now I'm going to insert my screws, one by one by one. I'm just putting them all in first, very lightly. Like so, and now we can screw the carburetor back together. I like to do them crossways, so I like to do nip that first and do the one diagonally away from it, like so, and then the others the same. Right on its side, it's easier. And this one. Last but not least, the other one. You just make sure that it's torqued down evenly as opposed to warping the top of the carburetor, which is not really what you want to do. So I'm just going to tighten down the last one. So now I'm going to tighten the last one and then tighten the opposite side. And here, and then here, and that's it. You now have a fully rebuilt Weber 26 carburetor, which should function like new. All you have to do now is replace the base. I would, just in case. You have this gasket which goes on here. And I've forgotten which way it goes on now, but yeah, so this goes on to the base, and then you've got the other gasket which is from the base onto the cylinder head. So yeah, there we have a fully rebuilt Weber 26. You've also got that one as well, which actually is the round, as this roundy gasket goes on here, just like so. We'll just slip that on quickly. That goes on here, and then just remember the nuts we took off. There's the washers. We have two nuts. Just a slip on here, like so. And last but not least, we have this one. And yeah. Here's your Weber 26, all rebuilt, all like new, really, really simple. To be honest, I don't even think you need to follow my video to be able to redo one of these, but just in case you get stuck, hope it helps you. Anyway, till next time, see you later.